I found myself in an awkward situation of being in somebody's driveway, which that happens, and I was wondering, because, you know, I sort of traced these maps by looking at the old maps and comparing and everything, and, you know, things have changed over 100 years. And so I didn't know if I was looking at the actual highway or not, because there really weren't any signs of any road even being visible. Well, I have definitely found a sign of a road, because I see over here behind me an old highway abutment, like going over a creek or something, or an old road grade, and I think that's the Jefferson Highway. So I'm gonna take a quick peek over there and look. Turn off of 69 to the west. We're coming into Pattonsburg, Missouri. Now, there's another video online about this area, and if I'm in the place where I believe I'm at, what will happen is I'll end up on a kind of a farm road, levee situation, maybe dirt, maybe something that's barely even passable. And I'll come up to a bridge that I cannot cross. It's a bridge that has been blocked off and is no longer used or maintained. And of course, I may end up in somebody's driveway. Possibly. Ah, here we go. Here's the road. See, there's a sign. It means there's a road. That's my story, and I'm sticking to it. And somebody's looking at me going, "What the hell is he doing?" Smells fresh around here. What do you think, doggies? Smell good? I have to relook at that video, but I guess some time ago this was, if there was ever a big accident or something on 69 Highway, local people would use this as a bypass. Go four-wheeling in here. Jefferson Highway, Pines to Palms. Did I let the doggies out so I can have a little out of the car break? Looks like Tickville to me. Also feels like it's getting a little bit soupy down here. And there's the bridge. Thank you. and surely it is blocked. All right, doggies, I'll let you out, but you're gonna stay on the leash. I don't want anybody disappearing in the woods. There's our bridge. Get some pictures. Well, we're on an abandoned segment of Jefferson Highway. You can see, four-wheel drive definitely helps. But the reason we came here is because of this bridge right here. It's been blocked off. See if we can make it up this thing without killing ourselves. And there she be. Remnant of the old highway. I'm sure I'm getting into all sorts of ticks and chiggers and poison ivy and all sorts of lovely things, but it is kind of beautiful up here, quiet, except for my yap yammering along. What you think, Jimmy? You get that bumblebee? What do you think, Stella? You having fun on the Jefferson Highway? What's going on, doggies? You having fun on the Jefferson Highway? Alright, I think we better head out before the serial killer shows up. Try and make it down here without killing ourselves. Come on, doggies. I'm glad y'all waited. I see you barreling into me and we'd all go tumbling down. Let's get out of here. So we've just turned off 69 to the north of the Grand River on another lovely, lovely road. And we're gonna see if we can come at the abandoned Jefferson Highway Grand River Bridge access from the north side. These roads here pretty much are just farm roads. All they're used for is so farmers can get to their fields with their equipment. Again, my wife asked me once, why do all the farmers always drive four-wheel drive pickup trucks? And I told her it's because of roads like this. And it looks like to get out of here, I may have to go use the highway, because there really isn't a road heading north. It's all been kind of covered up, plowed under. I mean, I guess I could do it and make it, but it's, I don't know. This here is questionable as far as, you know, private property is going. Farmer may go, what, who is that? What are they doing? You know, for the first time, I think I'm gonna put it in four-wheel drive. Just to make sure. I think I can make it in two-wheel drive, but I don't want to get stuck in two-wheel and then find out the four-wheel won't cut it either. You know, it's a good thing it's been raining. We really needed the rain. kind of questionable in four-wheel drive, honestly. As I was saying, we've needed the rain. I hope that we have a good year this year. Not too much, not too little. This is really indicative, I think, of what the Jefferson Highway was like, or what roads were really like before there were any highways. Get a little momentum and get through that quicksand there. Hope there's no quicksand. I might be rewarded here because on the other side you couldn't see the bridge at all, but here you can. That was pretty deep. We're having some fun now, aren't we, doggies? There's another questionable spot. The missus is gonna ask me, what have I been doing to the truck? Oh my God. I've been using it as a truck. Imagine that. And here we are. Looks like we're pretty much at the end of the... Oh no, it's still going a little bit more here. Because hey, it looks like the end of the road. And it looks like we even had something of a turnaround here. And even kind of a shady spot. All right, doggies, let's give her a try. I've made it to the other side. The doggies are enjoying themselves over in the tall grass over there. Lots of tall grass. There's Betsy and the farm road we used to get out here. And there's the Jefferson Highway Bridge. It's been abandoned for many years. And now I'm gonna get out of here because I've been hearing gunshots, so I don't wanna be the object of any target practice. So, okay, I think the mystery has been solved of Pattonsburg. I just came from Pattonsburg, which looked really empty and abandoned. And I'd seen this on a map, this like little area. It wasn't marked as a town or anything, but there was a lot of buildings and houses and stuff. Oh, it's very interesting. I guess I shouldn't laugh. It's probably really tragic, actually. Apparently, I think there's been a flooding problem in Pattonsburg, so the whole town has up and moved to here. And so this is a brand new town of Pattonsburg, but it's just called Pattonsburg. Brand new buildings. Looks like a strip mall, basically. But, I don't know, who knows, maybe in 100 years you'll look at this and go, wow, this historic old downtown Pattonsburg. Now, I'm guessing as to the nature of the move, whether it's flooding or maybe it's just to get it closer to a highway, but I saw signs of water damage and stuff in the area, so I think it's a... fact that the Grand River couldn't stay in its banks. This used to be more common back in the 1800s, towns would pick up and move. Usually take advantage of a railroad moving to a different location from the town for a better grade or whatever, but or a flooding issue or something. But I think this here has happened in the 21st century, so it's kind of interesting. Well, anyway. So, we've made it into Bethany, crossing what used to be railroad tracks here. I think I have a picture of that. Depot. I know. I'm shooting into the sun. But what can you do? Little time. Right, doggies? Bethany is the largest town farthest north in Missouri. After Bethany, you cross over to Iowa. But it's not like Bethany, Iowa. I think Bethany is in the center of one of the largest counties in Missouri. So, still have a ways to go. According to that hysterical marker we saw back there. I think we'll take this opportunity to let the doggies walk around. Looks like we actually have a clock to wind here. Maybe. The courthouse square. Yep, here's a courthouse. Shady spot where I can park Melba. Or I mean, Betsy. And hee. Bethany, Missouri. So you can't go that way. All right, I need to turn around to follow the Jefferson Highway out of town. Interesting. One way. Obviously, they don't want you to go that way. Oh, wait. This is the way I need to go.
Oh.
Somebody's black rabbit is loose. Looks like. I need to be up there, apparently, but can't go up there, it's one way. Sometimes you have that where the way you want to go is a one-way street against you, so a little park here. This, that's what the map says, is the highway. Wow, there's a lot of scrap metal in there. $2.35. I think the next stop, unless something else interesting pops up, is the Iowa border. So, found an old stretch of 69, pretty much abandoned. Probably, I hope it's not private property, but I didn't see any signs. You see these every so often, they straighten out the roads. Leave these abandoned pieces of highway. But sometimes the adjoining property owners will put stuff in the middle of them to keep people from trying to access. So we may have to turn around about down here. Sometimes people will pile stuff, or you know, like here, farmers will put equipment in the middle of it. Mostly because these roads can have a nuisance factor with kids who will go out in the middle of these roads middle of the night and party, or people will come along and dump stuff. Sometimes the property owners themselves will come out and dump stuff. Tires or whatever. Don't know if this is actually Jefferson Highway or not. I've been following the course of 69. My maps, I haven't found very good maps of this area, and the roads have been pretty modern. You know, the old highways of that era tended to meet at straight angles to each other. obviously we're in a part of the road where people use it as kind of like a residential street. But you know, these gradual grades and everything. This road probably dates to the 20s, 30s, or 40s, so it's pretty close to that era. You know, as I said, even when the Jefferson Highway was around, the process of grading and straightening and making the curves more gradual began. That was an interesting detour. We've made it to Eagleville, Missouri, small town. On the Jefferson Highway. Its purpose. Looked like some people had some neat shops in there. And we're continuing north. I believe we're coming up to the Iowa-Missouri border. The highway then, I think, and still does, make a sharp turn right at the border. Missouri portion of the Jefferson Highway. And I think I might continue on north to Lamoni. Which is in Iowa. I don't exactly know how to get there. Oh. That's probably the way. Alright. So we shall be crossing over into Iowa now. Welcome to Iowa. The people of Iowa welcome you. And oh yeah, we're an Amish country. Lamoni, Iowa, home of Graceland University. That's about all I know about it. Used to visit here when I was in the Scouts. We never visited downtown, so I've never been down here before. So I don't know what's down here. So let's go see. It a bit, and now we're through with the Jefferson Highway for now. We're heading home. I believe this is probably part of it. I don't know where it cuts off because I didn't load that part of the map in my phone. Our way home with all available speed. Actually, might stop at a truck stop on the way home. Get some vittles, unless I see something up here. Subway, no thanks. Lamoni First Baptist Church. HIV, I guess I could go in there. Boy, that is a small one. Until next time.